First of all, I just want to start off today to say hey, and I miss you to all the students that I have in all my classes at my schools and at the workshop. I really miss you guys, and it's been so long since we've been able to be together, and I think of you a lot, and sometimes I'll think of things that you've said and done, and I'll start to laugh, but I really do miss you guys, and I can't wait till we can get back together and work in person again. So I just wanted to start off the day by giving you a shout out and letting you know I miss you. So today we will be creating a 3D frog on a lily pad. You will have your frog cut out on white paper, and if you drew your own frog, you could have your own frog, or you could have cut out the template that we provided for you. And then you can have your lily pad cut out on green construction paper, or you could have that cut on white paper as well, and you can color and decorate it. So we are going to start by decorating our frog. And if you feel like just coloring your frog might be a little juvenile or young for you, you can kind of dress it up a little or everything by doing some black designs on them. You could get a black marker or a felt tip or a gel pen and do just different lines and shapes and designs. I think for lines, when you're using lines for your design, make sure you have a good variety. So you want to make sure that your lines are heavy and thin. You want to have dark lines and light lines. You want to have curvy lines and straight lines. So just kind of make sure you have a good variety of your lines there if you do the design. Or if you just want to color with your crayons or markers or colored pencils, whatever you choose to color with, you can decorate your frog any way you want. I know that today is just a simple craft project just to kind of help you stay creative and let you make something to kind of keep your mind working and going. And it just always feels good to be creative. I think that's something that we need to make sure we do on a regular basis. So start to decorate, color, work on your frog absolutely any way that you want to. There is no right or wrong. There are no rules. And I want you to really just remember that it's about the process of creating. It's more about that than the end product. So just enjoy it. Don't feel like you've made a mistake or you've done something wrong. I want you to just really enjoy working. And as always, be sure to upload a picture, send it to the Arts Council. We can see the projects that you're doing at home with us. So be sure to send those in. And also, if you need to pause the video at any time, you can do that. Or if when the video's over, you're not finished working, that is fine. That is okay. You can keep on working. You do not have to stop when the video's over, unless somebody at your house tells you that you need to. But otherwise, just keep on working. You don't have to work just the time that the video is. So I want you to create your frog. You can color it, do your lines and designs, any way that you want to do this. There is no right or wrong. Your frog can be pink, purple, blue, green, brown, or it can just have your lines and designs all over it. So just keep on working and just make sure that you're really enjoying it. You'll add all your decorations to it that you want to. You'll keep working on your frog. And there are a lot of different variations that you can do with your frog. If you wanted to give your frog eyes, you can do that. If you have googly eyes at your home, if you happen to have any, feel free to glue some googly eyes on them. Or if you just wanted to cut out black circles, you can do that and glue on there. Draw eyes, you can do that. You can even take some of your scrap paper where you cut your stuff out and just kind of ball up a little piece of paper. And that can be an eye. You can glue that on for an eye for your frog. So you can have an eyes for him if you want to. Another thing that you can add to your frog is also a tongue. You know, frogs have those long, sticky tongues that they lap out and they catch bugs and flies and things. So that's what they eat, and that's how they get them, with their long, sticky tongues. So you can get pink paper, or you can just draw a pink line on your another part of your scrap where you cut out your frog, and just cut that out. And see, our strip for our tongue is kind of straight right now, and there's a way that you can make it curly. So you'll want to very carefully open up your scissors, and you're going to take your strip and lay it over one of the blades, and you're going to put your thumb on top of it. And you're going to make sure you do this part very carefully, because if you press too hard with your thumb or you pull too fast, your strip of paper might rip. So you will just hold it over your blade with your thumb, and you'll gently pull your strip out. And see, it starts to curl. So then you can have a curly frog tongue for your frog. So you can have a frog, a tongue for your frog, eyes if you wanted to add that. And lily pads. When we think of lily pads, we think of those really beautiful lotus flowers that kind of float around with them. So you can even make a 3D flower to go with your frog and lily pad. You can layer a flower. You can have like two different sizes of flowers and cut in between the petals so that you can fold up the petals, and that will also give your flower a 3D look. So we'll fold up the petals here so you can have a 3D flower. Pretty flower. We'll roll those up. Just keep bending all your petals up. And you can even make a fly or a bug to put on your frog's tongue. So again, use your scrap paper. It's always a good idea to save your scraps, especially while you're still working. And then when you get ready to clean up, you can throw your scraps away. But while you're still working, you might realize, oh, I want to add this, I want to add that. And I can just draw a little tiny black blob on my scrap paper. And if you wanted to give it wings, you can give it wings. Or you could just have a black blob. Then you can cut out your little tiny fly. So you'll have a fly for your frog's tongue. He'll have some lunch there. I'm not going to be eating a fly for lunch today. There's the fly. Now, if you're not finished, you just keep on. I just want to make sure that I show you how you need to put this together when it's time. So to make your frog 3D, the way you're going to do that is you're going to take it and you're going to fold it in half. Fold it in half where his top side is on the outside. So you'll fold it, your frog, in half. And when you get ready to glue your frog on the lily pad, you're going to put glue only on his hands and fingers. So because his hands and fingers or toes or whatever, those will actually be the only parts of your frog that are actually touching the lily pad. So again, put glue. Don't put it all over your frog. You can put it just on his hands and feet and fingers and toes. You can put that on there. And you can put your frog on there any direction that you want to. So you'll hold your frog kind of over your lily pad, and then you're going to just press down on his hands and feet. So you're going to make sure that if you need to shift it some, kind of move it so that all four of his hands and feet have room on the lily pad. Another thing you can add to it is if you wanted to make a small baby frog to put on it with it, you can do that. But as you see, it kind of looks like your frog is getting ready to leap off the lily pad. So he's kind of 3D there. And you can bend his legs. You can kind of make him look however you want him to, whatever pose you want him to have. He can do that. So for your tongue, if you did make a tongue and you want to put a tongue on it, you will put just a little bit of glue on the top end of your tongue there, and you can just stick it under the frog's mouth. So then your frog will have a tongue. If you wanted to put a fly on it with it, you'll take your little fly, your little blob or whatever, and you'll glue that on the tongue. So there you go. He's got a little fly that he's getting ready to lap up and eat. And your flower, you can make your flower look 3D on there. Like I said, fold up your petals, and you can have just one flower, or you can do two, or layer three, however you wanted to do this. This is your project, and there is no right or wrong. So you can make this as simple or as intricate as you want it to be. This is yours. You can also color and decorate your flower or your baby frog, any way you wanted to do this. And see, it's all kind of 3D, the way you fold it and bend it. So if you do fold and up your petals and put a flower on there, only put glue on the middle, the back middle of the flower. So you'll have that. And then you've got this super cool frog. However said, if you your eyes, if you did Google eyes or you wanted to tear up and ball up eyes for your frog, you can have that on there. Or if you did your, if you didn't want to put it on a lily pad, if you kind of wanted to, I guess, dress it up a little, you could do your frog with your designs and lines on it and then mat it on just a black piece of paper or, you know, another color piece of paper of your choice. And so there you, and you'll have your 2D, your flat frog on there. So you can have that, put this together any way you want to. So there are endless possibilities. Next week we will come together and create a crayon resist art. And for this project you will need paper. If you happen to have thicker paper, like cardstock, you might want to use that, but if not, regular paper will be just fine. So you'll need your paper, you will need crayons, and a little bit of paint, whatever color you choose. You'll need a little cup because we're going to dilute our paint by adding just a little bit of water to it. And you'll need a paintbrush. So, yes, your paper, your crayons, your paint, your cup to mix that in, and your paintbrush to paint it with. So, thank you so much for joining us today with the Frog Lily Pad Project, and we will see you next week when we come together to create our crayon resist art. Thanks!